Parents of Reddit, in what ways have you almost accidentally killed your children? We were renting a two-story house when my son was about 2 years old. All of the bedrooms were upstairs and the windows, which led out to an overhang, were the floor-to-ceiling type and opened on the bottom. I thought I was being safe by putting child-proof locks in the kids' room windows. One day I'm downstairs while my son is napping and a neighbor comes over screaming, "There's a baby on your roof." He had gone into my bedroom and climbed out a window that wasn't locked. Grandma was visiting and doing some knitting. No sooner had the request, "Please make sure your 3-year-old grandson can't get a hold of one of those," come out of my mouth when I see him racing around the sofa brandishing a knitting needle. Time goes into slow motion. I can't see him and my legs, strangely, won't move fast enough. There is an odd silence. Then the crying. But it is a cry I've not heard before. It's gargled somehow, rounding the sofa. It's a scene for which I have no context. My son is sprawled on the ground. My brain first registers the blood, and then the bloody knitting needle. I turn him over and blood begins spurting from his neck and hits the coffee table. Grab PJ top and apply pressure. Scream at grandma to call 911. Grandma forgets how to use this crazy telephone. Husband runs in from garden. A blur of ambulance, attendants, neck brace, gurney, sirens, emergency room. There are ultrasounds, physical checks, stitches, monitors, and finally an overnight stay in hospital for observation. All is well. Arriving home, grandma said she thought we overreacted. Much later she will be heard to wonder aloud why she is not allowed to babysit. I feel obligated to say that we haven't held this incident against my mom, who is really a wonderful lady and excellent grandma. To those wondering if she feels guilty, no, she doesn't. Not one bit. At least not outwardly. Her worldview is a bit difficult to describe, but it goes something like this. Nothing bad ever happens, so this thing that is happening cannot possibly be bad. Tra-la-la da-dee-doo. Who wants cookies? This makes her a fun-loving grandma, but a poor choice as a babysitter. To those wondering how I survived to adulthood, I assure you my sisters and I appreciate that the probability that all three of us made it out of childhood alive was vanishingly small. Once while watching a 3-year-old, my godson, we went to a local model train store that he loved. Everything went great, and he had a lot of fun. Walking back to the car, he was tugging at my hand, and said, "I want to run." We'd made it past the last car in the lot except ours. No visible moving cars anywhere ahead of us, and it looked like absolute clear. Safe sailing all the way back to our parked car. So, I let go, and said, "Go ahead, run." It all seems so predictable now. He ran about 5 feet forward into the completely empty parking lot, towards our car, then did a 180 degree turn with a speed and agility that would make a hummingbird proud, and took off back the way we came. Back into the busy part of the parking lot. Trust me when I tell you that it is simply not possible for a 185 pound adult to change direction that quickly. Fortunately, I still had the presence of mind to yell stop at the top of my lungs. He stopped himself just short of a big SUV with its backup lights on. I think the driver may have seen him. I don't know. Anyway, here's what I learned about small kids. Just because traveling in a certain direction is obvious and natural to you does not mean your toddler thinks the same thing. All directions of travel are on the table. Toddlers can maneuver much more quickly than you can. You need to be holding your toddler's hand firmly any place there are cars. Even cars that could never, ever be a source of danger. Because they still can be. For everyone who has felt the need to point out how stupid I was to do this, believe me, I understand. I understand it so well that I've been on a guilt trip over it for the past year and a half. I get it, this whole post wouldn't be very useful or interesting if everyone shared what they did right. And trust me, if you ever spend any amount of time supervising small children, you will freak up at some point. No matter how prudent and observant you are, and no matter how many excellent books on the subject you read, there are just too many opportunities for something to go wrong. I'm an avid cyclist and part of my training route is in local park. On Sundays there are so many small children walking around. So I cycle almost at walking speed. Those little fellows can change directions faster than fighter planes. My worst nightmare is one running into my wheels. single mom here. I had this fake fireplace the first place that we lived, and I didn't know I had to bolt it to the wall. I figured it was heavy enough it would be fine. My 2-year-old son threw a ball and it went on top of the fireplace. As he climbed up to get it, the whole thing fell over. The only thing that saved his life was the beanbag chair we had set in front for story time. The fireplace weighed 200 pounds or more. When it tilted, he managed to get into the nook part so he wasn't getting completely crushed, and the chair kept the weight off of him. I had to get neighbors to help me lift it up. Scariest moment so far. Reasons like that are why I lift weights. Not a parent, but my sister took care of me a lot when I was a baby. One day I was playing in the laundry room and happened to get a hold of one of the silica packets from a shoebox. According to my sister, I somehow got it open and ate half the packet while she was in her room. After she found out, she was scared shitless and couldn't tell my parents. So she didn't and just watched me closely for the rest of the day, seeing if I did anything weird. Happy to say, I didn't die. TLDR. Baby eats silica packet. Sister too scared to tell anyone, so waits it out. The closest my son has ever come to danger was with my mom. I was there. This was mom's fault. We were loading purchases into the back of the car outside a department store. He was a little over a year old and was strapped into the seat of the shopping cart. I went around to turn on the car and get the AC going. My mom let go of the shopping cart to put her purse in and close the trunk. I stand up to see my son in the shopping cart rolling at a pretty good clip down the hill, through the parking lot towards the 4-lane highway. He saw me looking, lifted a hand and did that cute bending your fingers wave kids do. You have never seen two women take off running so fast. He is a teenager now, and anytime my mom criticizes me, I remind her of the time she sent him careening towards traffic. I'm not a parent, but once, driving a 5-year-old around, in the middle of the road he unbuckled his seatbelt and climbed out of the window. I noticed when his body was dangling halfway out of the car, was barely able to grab him by the leg and pull him back in. My heart had stopped. You avert your eyes for a split second and these kids find a way to lemming themselves. Holy frick, you just confirmed one of my worst fears. My son's just learned how to unbuckle himself. So until I can afford a new car seat, I just hope that the car lock system works. It blocks the windows from opening more than 10 centimeters and it locks the rear doors. My son is only 8 months old, and I've already got one. First, you should know that our house is about 100 years old and still has a boiler and radiators, steam, to provide heat. Since the house has settled, not all of the radiator pipes are angled as they should be. This can cause cold air to get trapped in the pipe, preventing certain radiators from heating up. The way to fix this is to remove the pressure regulator from the end of the radiator until steam comes out. This can take up to 10 minutes, depending on how long the boiler has been running, and the distance between said radiator and boiler. One day, the radiator in my son's room wasn't warming. It was nighttime and cold as heck outside, so I snuck into his room and unscrewed the regulator. Not wanting to wake him, I snuck back out, planning to return momentarily and put the regulator back on. Well, I forgot. For about half an hour, all of a sudden, as I'm doing who knows what downstairs, I'm wondering what the high-pitched whistling noise coming from upstairs is. I quickly realize my mistake, and dash to his room, only to find a cloud of steam so dense that I can't see anything. I feel my way to his crib and give him the scare of his very short life as I jerk him up out of a dead sleep and run out of the room. He was no worse for wear, just generally damp from the ridiculous amount of water in the air. After tending to him, I had to manually shut off the boiler and wait for the radiator to cool down before I could put the regulator back on. Then towel dry everything in his room, even the walls and ceiling. TLDR. Almost steamed my 4-month-old like a lobster. These things happen, man. Just be happy that you were in time. It's always tragic to hear such accidents on the news or to read it in the newspaper. What I don't understand is people forgetting their kid in the car for a whole day. This is not something my parents did, but something I did to my little sister when I was about 2 and she was roughly 6 months old. In my defense, I was trying to be nice. The rationale was as follows. I was apparently very fond of oranges. I would eat oranges whenever I could get my hands on them. I naturally thought my little sister would also like oranges. In my infantile mind, I then reasoned it would be a good idea to stuff her mouth with as many orange slices as possible so she could enjoy all that citrus. Why goodness. The result of all this is a 6-month-old girl rolling around on the floor unable to breathe until a screaming mother runs into the room and gets them all out. TLDR. Almost made my little sister suffocate on oranges. Best story happened to me. I was in my walker, dad left the garage door open. Bam, down a flight of concrete stairs. Ambulance and fire truck come and I am off to the hospital. Well, parents were in the middle of cooking dinner. Grandma came over to finish dinner. Started a oil fire and caught house on fire, which took out about a 1/3 of the house. Bam. Same fire truck and ambulance. Then after they leave, grandma has a heart attack. And you guessed it, same fire truck and ambulance 3 trips to my house in less than 5 hours. Peace, grandma made it. Well, she is dead now but made it through the heart attack. Boy, this one is a roller coaster. Down the stairs. GG grandma. House fire. Fire stopped. Heart attack. Lives. Dead now. When my oldest son was 2 years old, we went to a wedding being held in January. As we were leaving, there was a big patch of ice right at the bottom of the stairs leading out. My son had fallen asleep. I was cradling him in my arms so as not to wake him. Got to the bottom of the stairs, my fancy dress shoes slid on the ice out from under me. My legs flew back behind me. I yanked my son towards me and twisted so my shoulder hit the ground. Slid across the giant patch of ice while holding him and slammed face first into the tire of a car waiting near the entrance. My son's head was inches from the protruding metal bits of the rim. Little bastard didn't even wake up, but I was freaking hamburger meat. Nice instincts. You probably saved his life. When I was only 6 months old, my mom was running errands and had me in the car seat in back of the Jeep Wrangler we had. She buckled me into my car seat, but she was absent-minded, distracted, and forgot to strap the car seat to the back seat. She's driving along and takes a turn too fast and I shift from right side up on the passenger side to upside down in between the back of the driver's seat and the back seat driver's side. She notices right away, pulls over to get me right side up again. And she notices that my soft spot was about 1 inch from a protruding bolt. I don't think she forgot to secure the car seat after that. TLDR, almost got my soft spot penetrated. That's a nice TLDR for our knock and text. I'm not a parent, but I'm 10 years older than my sister and she got really good at climbing chairs at around 2-ish years old and managed to fall headfirst off of the chair. Fortunately, I saw it happen and managed to react out of instinct and dove across the kitchen. Not fully catching her, but slowed her down and she landed on my hands, which is better than tile. I also managed to throw my soda across the kitchen counter. I don't think I've ever reacted so fast in my life. I am also 10 years older than my little brother and sister. They're twins. And I also let my little brother fall off of the couch head first. I didn't halfway catch him though. My mom still doesn't know. But he is fine. You freaking Adama. When you see this, don't tell mom. Not a parent, but my mom has nearly killed me a couple of times. When I was a kid, my uncle got me this awesome military surplus backpack. I thought I looked really cool wearing it, but the downside to the backpack was that it had these really long drawstrings. One morning before school, I awoke to find my little brother had used all of my post-it notes and so clearly we needed to fight about it. Kinda dumb, but we were kids and that's kinda what we did. The whole event had put everyone in a bad mood and I rode to school in the backseat not talking to anyone. I got out of the car and slammed the door behind me. I took 2 steps before I suddenly was no longer able to walk forward anymore. I turned around to see that the extra long drawstrings from my awesome new backpack were closed in the car door behind me. My mother, not realizing this and still pee from the incident in the morning, floored it. The next thing I knew, I was on the asphalt kicking the wheels of the car trying not to get run over. You know that feeling in gym class where you slide down a rope too fast and your hands burn like crazy? Now imagine the rope is made of black top and instead of gripping it with your hands, you decided to use your whole body. My mom made it the length of our school's parking lot before the number of cars honking their horns made her stop to see what was going on. I rolled out of the backpack after she stopped, covered in blood and dirt. I was completely in shock, so I couldn't feel any pain yet, and I remember the first thing that popped into my head was that I was wearing my favorite Mighty Ducks shirt. This had totally ruined it. I totally didn't realize the gravity of the situation till everyone in the parking lot ran up to me to see if it was okay, and the pain started to set in. TLDR. My mom dragged me through a parking lot with her car. Holy crap. I'm glad you made it through that. I had an extension cable outside so I could vacuum my car. I had unplugged the vacuum and took it inside. I returned to start dealing with the extension cord, which was still plugged into the socket, to find my 3-year-old boy dunking it in the bucket of water I had to wash the car. I have no idea how he didn't explode. I remember sticking a fork in a socket when I was 3. I did it exclusively because my parents told me not to. Kids have to learn for themselves. When my daughter was 7 weeks old, I was returning from a local coffee shop with drinks for me and my husband. I was pushing our daughter in her infant car seat atop a stroller that came with it. I sat the car seat down on our couch and unbuckled her, then turned to take off my shoes and set down the drinks. In the blink of an eye, and before I could get to her, the seat tipped over off the couch and my baby fell face first onto the hardwood floor with a sickening thud. She began to scream and cry, and I was doing the same. I remember yelling, "Oh, my God, my baby, my baby." We ended up rushing her to the local children's hospital where she received dozens of x-rays and ended up having to spend the night to monitor her. She had a fractured eye socket that healed on its own. I was a hysterical mess, and, 4 years later, have not really forgiven myself for being so careless. TLDR. Don't put car seats on soft furniture. This happened to a co-worker a few years ago. She loads the baby, about 1 year old or so, in the car seat and heads to work. She drives to work, but forgets to stop at daycare and drop off the kid on the way. Fast forward to 2 hours later, when the daycare teacher called to ask if her kid was sick, she hadn't called to say he was staying home. Co-worker drops everything and races out to the parking lot to find her kid sleeping in the car seat in the car. Luckily, it was winter and not dangerously hot or cold, so the kid was okay. I'll start this by saying I am terrified of frogs. Absolutely terrified. My husband knows this and always terrorizes me with them. So on this fateful day I was holding our 2-week-old son when he walks in and drops a frog down my top. Of course my first reaction was to jump up and throw whatever was in my hands across the room. That was how my son had his first flying lesson. He turned out fine. Not a scratch on him. I hope your older child was sleeping on a very uncomfortable couch for a good long while. One day my cousin and I decided to go to a local beach with her baby and my younger sister. Her baby was maybe a year old, so when we went in the water she carried him. We started walking out into the deeper part of the lake but stopped when it was just below chest deep. I was maybe 16 at the time and about 5 feet 8. Out of nowhere she decides she's going to toss me her tiny little son. I wasn't paying attention but luckily saw the poor thing soaring through the air out of the corner of my eye. I turned and went to reach for him, but he had already fallen under the water. I plunged my hands into the murky water and by some miracle grabbed one of his arms and yanked him up. He was completely unscathed, he didn't even take in any water. Needless to say, we were pretty quick to get out of the water and never talk about that incident ever again. And that's why I will never take a child near any body of water. I'm 10 years older than my youngest brother, so I'm almost like a second mother to him. When I was 13, I took him, 3, and my other younger brother, 6, to the park to give my mom a break for the afternoon. I was swinging the 6-year-old on the tire swing and the 3-year-old decided he wanted to try. I was wary, but he convinced me he could hang on. He couldn't. He let go and he flew off that dang swing and smacked his head hard on the metal support. Knocked him out cold, and when he came to he was doing that silent scream thing that kids do when they're really freaked out. I called my mom on the phone and met her at the hospital, which was a block away. I gave him a minor concussion and myself a heart attack. I was loading my son into my truck at Costco a few months ago. He was sitting in the cart. I park at the end of the parking lot normally because I do not like door dings and the car stroller normally takes up a lot of room and I do not want to ding anyone else's car either. Well anyways, He was sitting there singing and just being merry, oblivious to the near-death experience he was about to encounter. Let me set the scene. I am parked almost at the very end of the Costco parking lot in a diagonal spot. There are three spots between us and the end of the lot planter. He rides in his seat on the passenger side of my truck's rear seat. The passenger rear door was open. I was at the tailgate loading some stuff into the bed of the truck. My wife had jettened into the front seat to put his diaper bag away. Then, out of nowhere, a large Suburban comes whipping around the front of my truck to turn around. Because going three extra spots and doing it on the road was just too much of a hassle. The Suburban actually hits my rear door. My wife was leaning into the front seat with the front door closed on her legs, or the truck would have hit her door too. Well, the door was hit by the Suburban, swings into the cart my son is sitting in and launches the cart into the path of a huge Ford F-350 coming up the row. He manages to stop. The Suburban spins tires to get the heck out of there, hit and run style. I grab my son, who is screaming at this point. The driver of the F-350 hightails it out of there as well. I am like, what in Jesus's frick just happened? I call the police to report the collision. Needless to say, we almost lost our son that day. He turns one today. Well, there is a silver lining as well. The driver of the F-350 was an off-duty cop and actually took the time to chase down the fleeing Suburban. Turns out the driver of the SUV was not licensed and was actually wanted on a warrant. So it was a good catch for him. I find it crappy that he just had little regard for life at that moment. He saw the cart go flying. I heard the lady with him scream at him that he just hit a baby. He still chose to flee. I was painting in the basement and using paint thinner to wash out my brushes. Having four children, we had a lot of those plastic cups restaurants give out with kids' meals. I used one of the plastic Chuck E. Cheese cups to put the paint thinner in, and after washing brushes for a while it turned a milky white. I went upstairs to grab something and suddenly my four-year-old ran up the stairs yelling, "My throat is on fire!" He had actually mistaken the paint thinner for milk and started chugging. They pumped his stomach and he survived. But my wife has not let me live it down. One night in the early 90s, my parents were cooking popcorn. Not popcorn in a microwave, like civilized human beings, but popcorn on the stove, like savages. As we all learned from Scream, this type of popcorn has a tendency to catch on fire, and so it does just that. We look up, and suddenly there are flames shooting up from our delicious evening snack. My sister freaks out a little. She's crying and screaming and just generally losing it, as six-year-olds tend to do after getting fire safety education in school. My dad calmly walks over to the stove and puts a lid on the pan. My dad's all, "Don't worry, it's out now." My sister is still freaking out and not convinced. I mean, the man didn't put water on it or break out the fire extinguisher or anything. But my dad insists it's fine and tells her to come over and look at the pan. She hesitantly walks over. Dad puts the pan right under her face so she can see the fire is gone. He removes the lid with a flourish, like he's revealing the exquisite main entree to a five-course meal. And the fire hadn't been smothered yet. The flames ray explode right in my sister's face. Singed her eyebrows right off. She still has some trust issues. I just laughed so hard at this one. I mean, your poor sister. But what a great story. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.